Any team news? I guess just Gio still, who is not available.
Yeah, I think so. Gio, of course, is not. And us, we still have two training sessions before the game. But I believe no more problems in principle.
I'm not going to inundate you with questions about transfers, but I just wanted to talk to you about some reports today suggesting that the club had decided against renewing Gareth's loan. He's still got plenty of time, hasn't he, to get fully match fit and prove himself. He's obviously proved himself as a character with his attitude at the club. What's your view on his future at the moment?
There was not even a second of discussion about that. Gareth is a player on loan until the end of the season. Not one second of discussion. And we are speaking about, of course, Gareth himself, Real Madrid, Tottenham. But I promise you, not one second of discussion.
We've got plenty of time to get back to his very best in terms of fitness and match time, hasn't he?
Yeah, of course, you know that he arrived injured. And he was injured for, I believe, the first month. And then, step by step, and Europa League matches were helping him to get his condition. Premier League, of course. Europa League group phase is a different level than the Premier League. The knockout is a different story, but the group phase is a different intensity, a different rhythm, a different quality. So in the Premier League, didn't play many minutes. Then another small injury at Stoke, where he was having a good first half, and now coming. Not an easy process. Everybody knew that in the past couple of seasons in Madrid, they were not easy for him. So let's go step by step and try to get the best out of him.
Thank you.
Yeah, I just wanted to ask one, Simon, about the celebrations, if I could, a final one. But the Premier League have underlined their COVID restrictions. On Wednesday, your guys were very low-key in celebrating the goal, as is required. Fulham, not so much so. They went for the full celebration. Is it, though, fair for them to celebrate a goal?
It is what we are asked for. And we have to try. And probably the best way is for the goal scorer to, if he wants to celebrate in a crazy way, let him doing alone. You know, before we always tell players, celebrate as a team. Don't forget the guy that assists. Don't forget the guys that are fighting hard behind you. Celebrate with everyone. But now maybe it's time to say, celebrate alone and let the other guys go to you in a calm way. I know that is difficult. I know that our players did it very, very well, but it's difficult to be critic with others that don't do it. But, you know, yesterday we had another meeting. This morning we had another one. If every club does the same, I want to believe that maybe only in extreme situation players will lose control of their emotions, but probably we can help each other to educate the players of not celebrating. So let's see. Let's try all together.
Okay, Ian Abraham. You're unmuted. You
going to
ask a question?
Hi, Jose. How are you?
Good, thank you.
Can I just follow up from that? I mean, are you actually having to get your players in training to practice, not celebrating after a goal. I mean, Harry Kane's always been very understated, but I just wonder whether you actually have to get your players around in training and say, right, let's score a goal and let's practice not going near each other.
No, not that. In training, in the day by day, in the training ground, what we are going to be, we always are, is very, very strict with what the Premier League asks us to do. So in this moment, no kitchen, separate dressing rooms, mask everywhere, even here. I just took it to speak with you. In training, not to work very, very closely, but not training, not to celebrate goals, you know. But yesterday we had a meeting with everyone. Today we had a meeting, myself with the captain, the Premier League again, which I suppose every club does the same. And we have to try, you know. We have to try. In my case, on the bench is easier. Of course, it's easier. Also, because I'm very influenced by the VAR, and when we score a goal, I'm always waiting for VAR and to confirm that nothing happened before. But for players on the pitch, I think it's a very individual thing. And again, my advice is for the guy that scored to maybe express the emotion of the team by himself, you know, by himself alone. You can maybe express all the emotion of the team, and then of course share a walk with the mates and share the happiness. But let's try to make things the best we can.
Football really has changed, hasn't it? Wickham's game tomorrow is off at QPR. Are you in any way worried about your cup tie there in 10 days time?
I'm not, because I believe then they will be nice and fresh and all ready to play against us, like is happening to many clubs that they have their matches postponed before they play us. But that's the way it is. So I expect to play them, and I hope we do.
And finally from me, you go to Sheffield United this weekend. Hanging on to a lead in a game. It's happened a few times recently. I was at Palace, finished 1-1. You've had games this week against Fulham, finished 1-1. Wolves, 1-1. What do you need to change when you hit the front to go on and win the game?
We need to score the goals that we can, and we need not to make mistakes that punished us. If you compare Hugo performance with Ariola performance, you have an answer. Ariola made, I believe, a couple of impossible saves that would kill the match. Also the post. And then defensive mistake and goal. That's it. Looks complicated, but it's simple because it's about a basic analyze of the game. A part of that, we can discuss many things. Of course, I don't want. Of course, I'm the first one that digs very deep to try to understand what my team has to improve and could improve and has to improve. I'm the first one to do it. But going to the basics, you score goals, you kill matches. You don't score goals, you stay in the limit. If you don't make defensive mistakes, you end by winning. If you make a defensive mistake, you can be punished.
Hi, Jose.
Hello.
How do you think Sheffield United compare this season to the side that beat Tottenham 6 months ago back in July?
The same. I don't look to the table. Of course I look, but I go deeper than that. And they are not the worst team in the Premier League at all. They are a much, much, much better team than what the table says. You look at their matches, you analyze their matches, and many times the opponent was not better than them, and many times was one of these small, big details that decides the score, decides the points, and decides the table. But they lose 1-0, they lose 2-1, they draw 1-1. They are a very good team. So honestly, if in our mind is we are going to play against the worst team in the Premier League, we are going to be in big trouble.
How big is the task do you think they face in staying in the Premier League and surviving? What kind of chances do you give them?
You have to ask Chris. I focus on two matches we have to play against them. And I promise you, I'm totally, totally convinced that we have to play well if we want to win those matches against them.
Just finally, going back to Gareth Bale, will he play a part in Sunday's game? And going forward, do you think you can just see yourself utilising him a little bit more?
I don't know. Didn't make a decision yet. We have to train today. We have to train tomorrow. Didn't decide the team. Let's wait.
I'll try to get through as many of you as I can. Just one question and a follow-up if necessary. We'll start with Jonathan Bill.
Hi, Jose.
Hey, Jonathan.
Hi. Do you expect Danny Rose to leave the club this month? And also, have you had any discussions recently with him about his future and everything?
Danny what? Danny leaving? I don't know. Honestly, I don't know. Working with the under-23s, playing sometimes with them, and well, the couple of times that I watch him, good contribution for the kids' team and for the kids' development. But I don't know what is going to happen in the market.
Thank you. We'll go to Alistair Gold.
Hello. Hi there, Jose.
Hello.
First off, just wanted to ask you quickly, you mentioned, I think it was a couple of weeks ago, or maybe even a week ago, about Steven Bergwijn having some muscular problems that were stopping him training with the full intensity. I just wondered how he's doing with that. Obviously, he wasn't in the squad the other day.
Yeah, he was ill. He was ill the week before. He was ill the week of Marin. And then he trained with the team only one day, which was the day before we play Fulham.
Okay. But in terms of the muscular injuries, is he getting over that yet, or is it still an issue?
No, it was not a muscular injury. It was not that. It was ill. He was not even coming to the training ground for a few days.
Hi, Jose. How are you?
Good, thank you.
I just wondered if you saw those comments from Marcus Rashford that he at Manchester United, he said it was after talking to you that they became a bit more savvy about winning penalties. Was that something that you remember?
Look, first of all, the Liverpool-Manchester United is a big match. That doesn't need me to make it bigger, or doesn't need me to do any headlines before such a big match that I know that means so much for both clubs and both supporters population. So I would leave comments maybe for later, but not for now. But if you feel the need to write something about it, do it in a very simple way. Stats, go to Opta, go to stats, go to my history as a manager in my 10 Premier League, more or less 10 Premier League seasons, compare numbers and take your conclusions.
Okay, finish with Dan Kilpatrick. Dan.
Hey, Jose. After the defeat at Sheffield United last season, you were quite critical of the players' mentality and said they needed to be better at responding to setbacks. Do you feel they are better now? Do you feel the mentality's improved since that game?
Well, I think probably we lost 2 matches in the last 18. And I think we are having some results, let's say some draws that could and should be victories, because were matches that we had in our hands, or to kill them or to keep them in the pocket. And I believe that the response has been always always positive. So that's it.